One evening, Eric bought me a bouquet of betonies. I asked, from where and why? He didn't respond to my question, touched my hair, scanned me from head to foot, but still said nothing. Walked away to his studio room, turned on his PC. He started playing his favorite FPS game, Modern Offensive, Blank Eyes. After a couple hours, he was done playing, so came back to me and said, I don't care about the violence in games, just wish it was only in virtuality. Maybe it's time we go to bed now. He was a difficult person to understand. Here I go again. Where's that freaking pill? I remember we were children, running in the fields with bare feet all day and going back home for supper. He used to tell me his dream about us. Walking together in Victorian gardens. I always thought those dreams would come true someday. Even if there would be no garden, we'd definitely be together. Sooner or later, those dreams would come true. How to ride a horse, this journey would take a lot less. There are new F12 model cameras. Should give it a try someday. Eric wasn't exactly a mingy type, but when it came to cars, I could never persuade him to buy a new one. He loved his old wreck, said his father gave it him on his 18th birthday, right after he graduated. It was sky blue, his favourite colour, and looked like a dead man walking. I remember its engine stopped working so many times. Those moments he never panicked. Got out of the car and fixed the engine in 10 minutes tops. Mechanics was kind of his speciality. At the college, we were at the same class. One day, it was literature exam, and the teacher was about to see him cheating from the book. I saw that and started to sing with a loud voice. The teacher got mad and took my paper, so Eric got enough time to copy all the answers to his paper. Later, he couldn't decide to whom he had to feel more guilty, but when the school ended and I failed the class... What if we never met? I'd probably throw myself into the wild many more times than I actually did. He wasn't so into the nature. Especially he was afraid of forests. The trees felt like giant monsters to him. I am quite the opposite to that. I find peace in the shadow of the trees. When I was a child, my father built me a treehouse, and Eric never came near it. He used to say, "You're going to fall and die, and when you do, remember what I say." He was trying to keep me secure, even when he was a child. Thank you. am at the centre of wild nature. Of course there will be a subway station. I'll have a look inside. Drink for being alone. What is this place? Am I losing it? A tree? Makes no sense. I think I'm going to fast forward from here to the hill where the grave is.